Hello and welcome to my channel AprilFlower Arts. I'm Tushara. A few of you had requested for a simple chocolate cake in pressure cooker. So today I thought of sharing my recipe for a basic chocolate cake in pressure cooker. Here I'm using eggs for the cake, but I'll also tell you how to make eggless cake and also vegan alternatives. Let's see how to make it. In the first step, we'll preheat the pressure cooker. For that, I'll add between 1 to 1.5 cup of salt to the bottom of the pressure cooker and make an even layer of the salt. For the pressure cooker cake, salt is very important as it helps to heat the pressure cooker uniformly and prevents the bottom of the cake from burning. So you can reuse this salt for about 2 to 3 times for baking. We'll also place the stand or ring that comes with the pressure cooker. I have placed the gasket along with it. You may slightly wet the gasket to prevent damage. We'll lock the lid. We'll not place the weight and we'll heat it at low to medium temperature for about 15 minutes. In the next step, we'll prepare the baking tray. For that, you will need a round 8-inch baking tray, or you may use the tray that comes with the pressure cooker. So we'll coat the bottom and sides of the baking tray with some butter or oil. And we'll sprinkle some all-purpose flour or maida and coat the bottom and sides of the pan really well. So this makes the surface really non-sticky, and remove the excess flour. But I like to place an aluminum foil at the bottom of the pan. It's really very convenient. You may even place a butter paper or parchment paper at the bottom. For the measurements, I always use these standard cups. One standard cup is 235 ml. These are the different cups, half, one third, and this is a standard tablespoon, which is 15 ml, and a teaspoon, that is 5 ml. Half and quarter teaspoons as well. So many of you have asked me about the cup measurements, so I'm just mentioning it here. If you Google, you can get all the conversions of 1 cup to grams. For example, if you want 1 cup of flour in grams, you can get the conversions easily, but I will also write it down on the screen as well as in the description box for you. So in the next step, we'll prepare the dry ingredients. For that, I'll take 1.5 cups, that is about 200 grams of all-purpose flour, that is maida, half a cup of natural unsweetened cocoa powder. Here I'm using Hershey's cocoa powder, which is natural 100% cocoa powder and unsweetened. 1.5 teaspoons of baking powder, quarter teaspoon of baking soda, and quarter teaspoon of salt. So we'll just sift all these ingredients using a sieve so that there are no lumps of the flour, baking soda, and cocoa powder. Using a fork or whisk, we'll mix the ingredients really well and form a uniform mixture. Alright, the dry ingredients are done. So next we'll prepare the wet ingredients. For that, here I have 3/4 cup of unsalted butter to make sure that it is soft and at room temperature. Instead of butter, you may use any refined oil or flavorless cooking oil. Into that, we'll add 1.5 cups of sugar. If you want a sweeter cake, you may add up to 1 3/4 cup of sugar. And if your sugar has bigger crystals, you might have to powder it in a blender and then add. Next, we'll cream the butter and sugar. That is, we have to mix the butter and sugar really well. For that, you may use a fork or a whisk like this, or even an electric mixer. So if you continuously beat for about 1 to 2 minutes, you can see that it becomes really creamy, light and fluffy like this. So this is what the consistency we need. Into this, next we'll add 3 eggs. We can substitute the eggs with 3/4 cup of condensed milk. And if you are using sweetened condensed milk, you may have to add sugar half the amount. And for vegan option, you can add 3 tablespoons of flaxseed powder mixed in half a cup of water. We'll break in the eggs one at a time and whisk it in. I mixed in the egg and we have to whisk it for about 1 to 2 minutes until it becomes really nice and airy and fluffy and light. Into this, I like to add 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. So this is optional. Next, this is an optional step. I like to add 1 teaspoon of instant coffee powder dissolved in around 1/4 cup of warm water. This helps to intensify the chocolate flavor of the cake. Next, we'll add 1/2 cup of plain yogurt. Helps to give a very soft and moist cake. You can substitute it with milk, and for vegans you can substitute it with almond milk. At this point you may see that the butter will curdle a little, but that's okay. When you mix in the dry ingredients, it will be all fine. In the next step, we'll add the dry ingredients into the wet 1/3 at a time and slowly mix it in or fold it in. Alright, the batter for the chocolate cake is all done. It's very thick, smooth and fluffy, but of pouring consistency. So now we'll transfer it into the baking tray. Smoothen it at the top to make it look even. Alright, the cooker is nice and hot. We'll now place the baking tray with the batter. We'll close the lid along with the gasket and we'll not place the weight. We'll bake the cake at low to medium temperature for about 50 to 60 minutes. The cake baked for exactly 50 minutes. However, it may take less or more time depending on your pressure cooker. You may check it around 40 to 45 minutes by inserting a clean knife or toothpick in the center of the cake. And if the knife comes out clean like this, it means that the cake is completely cooked. And if you find that the batter is still sticking, you may bake it for another 5 to 10 minutes. This cake has been cooling for about 5 minutes now. You can see that it easily leaves the sides of the baking tray. Alright, the chocolate cake has completely cooled down. It has got a really nice height and very soft and spongy. You may go ahead and decorate it as you wish. You may cut it into half horizontally and add a layer of icing and also on the top, or just serve it as such with a scoop of vanilla ice cream. I like to decorate it with some cherries and berries. Dust some icing sugar. Or you might just pour some chocolate sauce onto it and some chocolate shavings. So I'm gonna cut a piece now. It's really very soft. The knife just slides in very easily. So this is how the cake looks from the inside. It has got a very nice height and very soft and spongy. So go ahead and make it for your loved ones or treat yourself with fresh homemade delicious chocolate cake. If you like the recipe, please give it a thumbs up. And if you're new to my channel, please subscribe and click the bell icon to get notifications of my latest uploads. Until next time, it's bye from me. Thanks for watching.